Hi everyone. So other configs which you can maintain in the application is like npm rc, ESLint rc, or SQLize rc. It depends on the modules. So like if you are using MySQL in your application, then you may be able to create a SQLize rc. Or if you are using, because we are already using npm, so you may need npm rc if you are using, if you wanted to set some configs parameter in your node environment, npm environment, then you can do it like this. So you can see like you have a private npm repository. By default, all the npm install points to the npm js repository, npm js registry. But if you wanted to have your own organization private repository, then you can point to that particular repository only. So if I talk about npm config, then you will get all the npm configs which are already configured, that my node environment is pointing to this, okay, and my npm registry is pointing to the main registry of npm. Okay, this is the user agent and current working directory and all these things. So npm config, there are multiple commands. If you can see npm config set, delete, or get, so you can set your other npm environment parameters. Other than that, if you are using the Docker, then you might be using docker compose.yml, gitignore, eslint rc. We are using eslint for the code quality and code integration, so we are using the eslint rc, that file. So these are the minimal configuration which you need to maintain, and all the package scripts, npm scripts, will be putting in the script tag. Okay, now coming to managing the environment in the application. So what you can do is like, if you wanted to pass some environment while starting the server, okay, you can pass it like this. So port is let's make it 3000. So these are two environment variables I am passing while starting the node server. So how can I capture these environments, because you might be, your application might be having different environments. So you can capture it using the process environment variable. Like I'm starting my server in the index.js, so I can do it like this. So it will, what I have done, like I can define the multiple ports for multiple environment in the package.json. So here you can see, so here I can say start test, and different environment I can pass test port can be 3001, 3002. Right. So like this, you just need to execute that particular command only. Let's make it small. So what it will do, it will hit this particular command. Okay, now your application will be starting on 3002. Here also you can make it dynamic. Or let's put it around backticks in the ES6 style. Okay, now it is running on 3002, right? So in this way, you can pass the multiple environment variables from your package.json or some script. Here I'm passing the environment also, so you can also get the environment value in your index.js. If nothing is there, by default it's a development. Okay, now I'm doing it. So you can see running environment UAT and port is this. Okay, so this is just a basic setup. In future we will be adding the PM tool and different logging, error handling and all.